Here the tides flow. That's the signature line of Newfoundland's greatest poet, E.J. Pratt, followed as in nature by And Here They Ebb. On July 2nd, 1992, they ebbed with a vengeance, a date that, in my mind anyway, has as its only rival March 31st, 1947, when we joined Confederation. John Crosby on that day, brave man that he was and is, went to a wharf on the southern shore to announce the cod moratorium. It's always bad news when government announcements reach for Latin nouns. Well, from the days since Elizabeth I was queen and John Cabot on a search for China stumbled into Bonavista, the fishery drew people here. And on that day, it was denied the mainstay of the Newfoundland generations and all the trade and craft that went with it. Economically, the moratorium was savage. All Newfoundland inshore fishermen instantly found themselves without work. Culturally, the hit was greater. The greatest, most significant continuity in the tenacious Newfoundland way of outport life had been snapped, the cord broken. The fishery was, in all the ways that count, the be-all and the end-all of the Newfoundland way. It determined how the island was settled. It set the patterns of life, language, and livelihood. It was dotted with hardship and tragedy, and it also bred resilience, inventiveness, high spirits, dark humor, and hospitality. Psychologically, I'm not sure the collapse of the Newfoundland fishery is fully measured now. It ripped the heart out of our intimacy with the sea, put a stay on the cruel and joyful exchange it's always been both between Newfoundlanders and what they have always known and done best. Cope with a hard life of precarious toil, yet find a measure of joy and triumph in making do. Most of all, it put a seal on outport life, the great nursery of the Newfoundland tongue, the font and fountain of folk music, story, and song, and the tablet on which a unique way of life was engraved. Out of the cramped and yet rich life of the outports emerged the full strength and force of Newfoundland character, which found its highest representation in the dramatic chronicle of the great artist and printmaker David Blackwood. His prints, The Labrador Fishery, The Seal Hunt, and Life on the Northeast Coast, shoot the story of Newfoundland into realms of myth. Newfoundland life and culture have always been the outport. St. John's is merely the biggest one. And with the moratorium began the unraveling of its reason to be. With the fishery closed, the young and old, particularly the young, fled to other shores, out west to Alberta, which was a great salvation for many, further afield to the oil rigs off Mexico and the African coast. The economic focus shifted to the offshore oil. Both began the unpeopling of the historic coastal communities. They are now, so many of them, shells of their former being, places to visit more than to live in, and sirens for tourists, heart-stoppingly deanimated vessels of nostalgia. The fishery may return, but never as it was. It cannot. 25 years ago, a tide ebbed that may never be full again. For The National, I'm Rex Murphy.